Hello students, in this video we'll be discussing about the important terms from our chapter Cell, the Fundamental Unit of Life. The terms are osmosis, plasmolysis and membrane biogenesis. These three terms are important ones that we have already discussed in our previous videos, but then to make it more clear, I wanted you to explain this separately. What is the definition of osmosis, my student? Osmosis is movement of water molecule from higher concentration to a lower concentration through a selectively permeable membrane, right? In the figures, let us see in the figures what is being given to us. In the first figure, you are able to see your left and the right side of a beaker. Here it is separated through a partially permeable membrane. That is nothing but it is selectively permeable membrane, right? Here on the left hand side, the amount of sugar is more, that is red dots are more. On the right hand side of the beaker, the amount of red dots is less. The red dot indicates the sugar particles and the blue are the water particles. So what will be the movement of the water molecules? Where the water molecules are more, right, my students? So it is in the right side of the beaker. So from right side of the beaker, the water molecules will start moving towards the left side. Clear? And what we will get in the result? The amount will reduce. Here you can see the amount of solution is reduced because water molecule has moved to the left hand side. Clear? In the next figure also you can understand here. The green is the sugar molecules and the blue one are the water molecules. Here more water molecules are there. I should use the other color, I think. Here green is the sugar, blue is the water. Here more amount of water is there. That's why the movement is towards the right. Clear? So this is what about the osmosis. Students, the next thing that we have to discuss is about different types of solutions, right? Different types of solution. In the videos I have discussed, there are total three types of solution, osmotic solution. Those are hypotonic, hypertonic and isotonic. What does that indicate? Here in the when we are talking about any kind of solution, solution is made up of solute and water. What is a solute? It is something that is added to it, right? It is something that is added in the water. For example, sugar in water, right? So what is a sugar? Sugar is solute, right? Whereas water is solvent, right? Water is solvent. Clear? So solute and solvent is clear to you? Very good. Moving ahead, hypo and isotonic solution. Hypotonic solution is hypo. Always remember in the simplest way, hypo, water is more. Hyper, water is less. Iso, water and solvent are same. Clear? Now, looking into the above figure, we have to discuss. Looking into the above figures, we will be discussing about what type of reaction takes place inside the cell when the cell is kept into hypo, hyper and isotonic solution. Now when the cell is kept in hypotonic solution, right? When the cell is kept in hypertonic solution and isotonic solution. When the cell is kept in hypotonic solution, here again in the same slide we are discussing it's same here, but we have to discuss in terms of animal and the plant cell. So I wanted you to discuss it over here. Hypertonic solution, iso and hypo. In hyper, water is less. So what will happen? Water from the cell is coming out. You can see from these arrows, right? And that will lead to shrivel, that is shrinkage of the cell. If the cell is like this, the cell will start shrinking. Clear? Now, in isotonic solution, water outside the cell and water inside the cell is same, right? So when you are keeping a cell in any solution, the amount of water outside the cell, that is in the solution, and the amount of water in the cell is same. So there won't be any change. So cell will remain normal. In hypotonic solution, what will happen? The water will start moving in, right? And animal cell will lyse. What is the meaning of lyse? It is, the meaning of lyse is the cell will die, right? Whereas in plant cell, cell is not going to lie, my dear. It is to convert into turgid, right? Because of presence of cell wall, right? My dear students, why it is so? It is because of presence of cell wall. Clear? Right? Okay. So, again discussing, in hyper, the cell will shrink. Animal cell will shrink, and in plant cell, plasmolysis will take place. Because what is plasmolysis? I will discuss in the next slide. Why there is a difference in animal and the plant cell? Because plant cell has the cell wall, right? They have cell wall where we doesn't have cell wall. That is in animal cell, cell wall is lacking. That's why, my dear students, in hypertonic solution, animal cell will shrink, whereas plant cell will plasmolyze. In isotonic solution, animal cell will remain normal, whereas plant cell will flaccid. Flaccid meaning, what is the meaning of flaccid? Flaccid, that means the amount of water will be more, go on adding and adding, right? It will be in the normal stage, right? In hypotonic solution, animal cell will burst, will die, whereas plant cell won't be bursting because of the presence of cell wall. Clear? Okay. Next is plasmolysis, right? Again, this is important term. All the three terms that I am going to discuss are the important in this chapter. You have to remember, because these terms will be coming in higher grades as well. Plasmolysis. Plasmolysis is a process in which a plant cells where the plasma membrane pulls away from the cell wall. Right? In the previous videos, I have discussed that in plant, plasma membrane is present. Right? What will happen as the cell wall won't be any change that will take place in the plant cell, that is in cell wall of the plant cell, whereas plasma membrane along with the cytoplasm will start moving away. You can see in the first figure, this is plasmolysis, right? When the water comes out, water moves out from the cell, the plasma membrane will detach from the cell wall and it will start losing water and will start shrinking. Clear? This is plasmolysis. Second thing is flaccid that we have discussed. If you keep this cell back into water, then what will happen? Either of this thing will happen. The plant cell will start regaining, and that process, my dear student, is known as deplasmolysis. Clear? Right? What is plasmolysis? Plasmolysis is a process in plant cells where the plasma membrane pulls away from the cell wall due to the loss of water through osmosis. Right? This only takes place in plant cell, no animal cell. Moving ahead to the membrane biogenesis, the last one of this video, last definition, important one. What is membrane biogenesis? Is a process which involves the synthesis of cell membrane. Right? Membrane, Okay. Membrane is the outer covering of the cell, organelles, right? With the help of proteins and lipids. This also we have discussed in my previous videos, that membranes are made up of proteins and lipids. Now, who produces these proteins and lipids in the cell? It is endoplasmic reticulum, right? Endoplasmic reticulum is responsible for the synthesis of membranes, because these two products are synthesized inside the endoplasmic reticulum. Membranes of the cell altogether are called as endomembrane system. ER, that is rough endoplasmic reticulum, because of the presence of ribosome, it will produce protein, my student, right? Whereas smooth endoplasmic reticulum, it doesn't have anything, it will produce lipid. Clear, my student? Right? So that is membrane biogenesis. Membrane biogenesis is the process which involves the synthesis of cell membrane with the help of proteins and lipids. Clear? With the help of proteins and lipids, who produces it? Endoplasmic reticulum. That's it. Thank you.